Hey there, in this video I'm going to show you how to set up drag and drop column supports in Gravity Forms and have those columns display in the PDF. So the first thing we need to do is add a new form for list columns, and we'll set up some drag and drop columns. Let's duplicate this. Turn that into a two-column layout. Then we might add some checkboxes. Make it a column by dropping it with the little arrow next to it. Just put a label on these. So it's easy to see that they're in the right order. Three. I add in date, time, include a phone number, and we'll add a checkbox. Gravity Forms allows you to create up to four columns. So you can do no columns, just a single field in a row. You can do two column, three column, and four column layout using drag and drop. Now I could use a consent field, but it's a lot bigger in terms of, I'll just go ahead and add it, use a little search, because normally you add your consent agreement text, and so it'll add a box there. So you can use this consent field here. We can use it without the description. You can see I can't actually drop it in this row because there's four there. But if I delete one and add a new one, I can add it there. Some other cool things you can do with columns is I can actually set the column width myself. So you're not fixed with these particular fixed width columns. I could make this borders. Maybe I'll make it a little bit smaller so I can fit in. Done. There we go. So I could have this taking up 75% and this one taking up 25%. I could reduce this down and make it the reverse, which is a cool flexible width feature to have. I can also not add any additional columns and just resize this down if I want. That's a full size one, and this one quite small. And I'll just hit update. So Gravity PDF is going to match the layout you've used here. So it'll display the PDF and the fields in it in the same column structure that's been used here. If I preview that, we've got our two column layout top, and then we've got three columns, four columns. This consent field's got no columns. Then we've got our name field and number field, which is 80%, 20%, our full width email, and our 25% email. Go ahead and fill all those out. doesn't really matter what the data is for this demo. Another name field. And probably should have put Jake and Ben. Change that. Okay, and hit submit. Now, if I go up and configure a PDF on this form, create one. And we'll change it over to Rubix, one of the other templates, and hit add. If I view this PDF now, we'll have our two column layout, and then our three column layout, and then our four column layout. You remember the consent box was full width, then we had 80%, 20% width, a full width email, and then a partial width email. Now, the really cool thing about these core templates is they match the form. So I could go ahead and add new fields in, and it's going to automatically update the PDF if there's a value in it. Or I could change the column widths. I might decide I want a bigger name, less age here, and I want to make I can't adjust those ones. I want to make this name and number a bit more even, and I want to make the email address take up about half instead of that small space. So I'll just zoom out now and refresh. And you can see that our name and age have been updated automatically. And so is our email and name and number here. This is a really cool thing about how these core templates and our universal templates keep up with the form changes you make, because it's generated, it's powered by the form fields you add to it. So it's each of those PDFs are going to be different depending on the form you use. We'll go ahead and we'll delete a couple of these fields just to give you another quick idea on what can happen when you refresh. So they're automatically disappeared, and this PDF has been updated to reflect those form changes. And that's it for drag and drop columns in the PDFs. All the core templates support them. The version 2 core templates and all the universal templates that have column support this new drag and drop column feature. Refer to the documentation for each universal template to see which ones actually have column support and which ones don't. The ones that don't are for design reasons, to get the look and feel of those particular templates. Columns aren't supported just because of limitations in the PDF rendering software. So just keep that in mind if you are using any of our paid templates. Just to check the documentation to see what does and what doesn't support them. And enjoy the new drag and drop column feature. It is amazing. A lot better than the old CSS ready class system that Gravity Forms was using.